Do you miss hockey? I know I certainly do. I miss the fast-paced action, roar of the crowd, and the goal horns. Oh, the goal horns. It's been 4 years since the original list was uploaded, so let's see what's changed. Here are the top 10 NHL goal songs of all time. Number 10, Rock and Roll Part 2, The Colorado Avalanche. Gary Glitter did a very bad thing. We know this. That said, it's hard to argue the impact of Rock and Roll Part 2, considering that literally everyone used it. But this is the best one. All the heart-piercing sirens and horns gave the impression of an actual avalanche warning, which is what it was like playing Colorado in their first 7 years in Denver. A powerhouse at the turn of the century, Colorado's avalanche warning comes in at number 10. Number 9, Shot Down in Flames, the Calgary Flames.
And the puck was loose for just a moment. Now again, it takes a shot. The rebound, in fact, Donovan!
I was 5 years old, living in Calgary in the spring of 2004, and this song was inescapable. A classic off 1977's Highway to Hell record, AC/DC would rock the Saddle Dome every time Jerome Iginla and the Flames ripped a puck past an opposing goaltender, and it was glorious. Matched with Calgary's amazing in-game presentation, this song ruled Southern Alberta until it was replaced by Barbra Streisand by Duck Soup in 2009. Weird times, I know. Number 8, When the Blues Go Marching In and the Blues Have the Urge, the St. Louis Blues. How do you take an existing classic and improve on it in every way? Call the urge, apparently. St. Louis went from worst to first in 2019, and along with a pretty infamous win song, worked their way into the hearts of hockey fans everywhere when they beat Boston for the Stanley Cup. The classic organ from Jeremy Boyer fades into the jazzy rock number from the St. Louis band The Urge, and the crowd starts chanting, perfection in the gateway to the West, if you ask me. Number 7, Maria, I Like It Loud, the Philadelphia Flyers.
Rattled on around now, and it's Carl. Pops it onto the corner and goes to get it, but it's Voracek there, turning away from Zidlitsky. Back to Briere. Fire! Score!
Okay, let me compose myself before I start. Doop 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 da da doop doop doop. Second only to the Bring Back Holiday movement, Flyers fans petitioning to bring back Doop has been the most consistent goal horn related conversation of the past decade. This song got its love during the 2012 playoffs, during that bloodbath with the Penguins, which is a top 5 best playoff series of all time, where Philly bounced the Pens in 6. Not to say that Philly has had bad goal songs since then, but nothing compares to Duke. Honorable mention to Booyah, though. Number 6, Party Hard, the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Working it back in deep. Fresh from the bench, it's Crosby. Crosby on Kunitz's shot. Penguins win it! And they go to the final!
The The biggest omission of the 2016 list, mostly due to the fact that it had only been around for about 3 months when I made the last video. Back-to-back cups for the Penguins led to the Andrew W.K. Smash from 2001 becoming Pittsburgh's favorite party song. And remember, winning back-to-back Conn Smythe trophies counts as partying. Number 5, Brass Bonanza, the Hartford Whalers.
Hawks lose this way, Sanderson after it, Castle's behind the goal, right out in front, there's the...
The definitive old-school goal horn. The Hartford Whalers had one of the greatest goal songs of all time, but also an atrocious goal horn that takes some getting used to, especially if you're not a Whalers fan, and thus have no connection to it. This served from the late 80s until the Whalers left Hartford for Carolina in 1997, and returned in 2018 with Whalers Nights in Carolina, a semi-regular occurrence that happens to this day. Good PR move by the Hurricanes. Number 4. For those about to rock and the whip, the Columbus Blue Jackets. Five words. They have a motherfucking cannon. The AC/DC/Loxley mashup works just as well today as it did at the start of the last decade, and they have a motherfucking cannon! Number 3, Chelsea Dagger, the Chicago Blackhawks.
Here's Kane with Taves! Kane, backhand shot!
Overuse in the minors and junior leagues has led to this iconic goal song dropping a spot from the last list, but you can't deny how important this song was to Chicago's identity during their reign of dominance through much of the 2010s. Today, Chelsea Dagger is second only to Sirius by the Alan Parsons Project as the city's unofficial anthem. Number 2, Slapshot, the New York Rangers.
They can't get out with it. Follow up from Markov. Very careful trying to play it a second time, can't do it. Here's St. Louis moving in.
Ray Castagnoli wrote and performed this classic goal song during the lockout of 1994, and when hockey returned in January of 95, the Rangers were ready to rock and roll with one of the greatest goal songs of all time. 25 years later, it's still the anthem of the Blue Shirts and is heard more than any other song in Madison Square Garden, except for maybe Piano Man. And the number one greatest goal song of all time is Holiday. The Vancouver Canucks.
Kessler just tipped the puck by Boychuk, throws it in the middle. Yannick hands into Tom.
If you want to call it bias, you can. But Holiday represents one of the best times in my childhood. One of, if not the best team in the NHL at the turn of the decade, the Canucks scored often, and Holiday was the song to ring through Rogers Arena as they marched to 3 division titles, 2 President's Trophies, and a Stanley Cup Finals appearance. It briefly returned for the 2019 season, but has since gone away again, stolen away by Vancouver's game day presentation team. We can only hope that, as the Canucks continue to get better, Green Day will once again blast through the speakers at Rogers Arena. And that's my list. What do you think? Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know in the comments section below. Until next time, I'm Joey Pitt. Thanks for watching.